So let us see some of the expression ambazo tunaweza tukazipata, the mathematical aspect of satellite motion. So assume you have the Earth and you have a satellite that is moving around the Earth. Yes. So if we're having this as the Earth, we're having a satellite moving around the Earth with this being the satellite orbit. Remember, just like any other circular motion, it will be having a linear velocity v, that is the orbital velocity, and an angular velocity, of course. So if ME is the Earth's mass and R is the radius of the Earth, such that the distance from the center of the Earth to the satellite is R plus H, R being the radius of the Earth, and H being the height from the surface of the Earth up to the satellite ilipo. V, as I said, being the orbital velocity, the velocity V, the linear velocity that the satellite is having while circulating or revolving around the Earth. And therefore, by circular motion, we know that centripetal force is given by mv squared divided by r, r being the distance, I mean the radius of the circular path that a particular body is undergoing the circular motion. And therefore, if the centripetal force is given by mv squared over r, remember the m here is the mass of the body that is undergoing the circular motion. Here we have m as mass of satellite, v as orbital velocity of the satellite, and r plus h, the radius of the cycle, okay, that is the satellite is moving, revolving around the center of the Earth. And therefore, our gravitational pull of the Earth on the satellite, we also have it as, remember the universal gravitational law, that force is given by universal gravity constant, gravitational constant, times product of masses, where that force is direct proportional to the product of masses, where here is the mass of satellite and the mass of the Earth, and divide by, and so it's also inverse proportional to the square, which is the inverse square law. And therefore, the distance from the center, the mean distance from the center is r plus h, and therefore it is r plus h squared. So we know that the centripetal force for this case, it is circular motion, and therefore the centripetal force is the gravitational force. So this gravitational force, gravitational pull, is the one that is the centripetal force. And therefore, if we equate the two, we get that the velocity here, we have our expression, that mass na mass will cancel, r plus h will cancel with 1 r plus h, and itabaki r plus h. And therefore, we have v square is equal to g mass of Earth divided by r plus h. And therefore, v being the orbital velocity will be given by the square root universal gravitational constant times mass of the Earth divided by the distance center r plus h. So this is our expression for orbital velocity. So remember, this in the example ya satellite motion ambayo tumefanya assumption kwamba the center of the motion, the center of the cycle ni Earth na another satellite. It can be anything. Center of the cycle inaweza ikawa the sun, na hiyo the satellite ikawa the Earth. So usikariri kwamba the velocity v ni sawasawa na g mass ya Earth over r plus h. Inabidi uelewe kwamba hii mass ni ya body ambayo itakuwa katikati. Kwa kama you are given satellite motion na center of the motion, the body at the center ni the sun, hii inakuwa ni mass of the sun. Kama ni sivyo, ni moon, ni sivyo, ni Jupiter, sivyo nini, it can inakuwa ni mass ya the body at the center of the cycle. Lakini vile vile I take this opportunity to highlight something else important. How do they place satellites kwenye space? So tulisema kwamba this satellite lazima iwe projected vertically. Okay, inakuwa projected into space. Na ikifika at a desired point ambayo anataka i undergo circular motion, it needs to be given an impulse. Lazima ipewe force. a force big enough to give it horizontal velocity is now contribute to centripetal force, because we know centripetal force F ni sasana mv squared over R. So kuna kitu hapa ambacho ni very important to note. Kuna two velocities, velocity of projection, note that, please write. Kuna velocity of projection, Okay? Na kuna velocity, hii tuliko tunayongelea hapa, the orbital velocity. Orbital velocity ni velocity ambayo itakuwa inaenda nayo. Okay, the velocity ambayo inasababisha hiyo body undergo circular motion kwenye hiyo orbit wanaoitaka. It's the orbital velocity, velocity ambayo itakuwa ina move nayo in that orbit ambayo wameipata. Okay, so let us see how we can derive this expression ya hii velocity. So basically it is just the same, ni kama hii hapa. Okay, the formula is just the same ya orbital velocity. So ukiambiwa how much velocity ambayo inahitajika ku make this body ku undergo that motion, usually is the orbital velocity wanayoiongelea ni hii, ni hii orbital velocity. Okay, as we shall see in some of the examples hapo mbele. So hii inaweza ikawa na many forms, you know kwamba we also know kwamba g m ni sawa sana g r e squared, right? So in other words, e formula ya orbital velocity can be improvised. V ikawa ni sawa sana g r e squared divide by r plus h. Okay, just remember kwamba this is r plus h na hii huku ni r e squared, g r e squared, so do not confuse them. Hii ni radius of the earth na huku chini ni r plus h, which is the distance from the center. So the radius hiyo e plus h, as it has been shown. Bring all your concepts ambazo tumesha soma so far kuhusu gravitational motion. Remember that satellite is no different, haina exception. Ni kwamba kuna vitu ambavyo vichache vitaongezeka, such things kama binding energy, such thing kama escape velocity, as we shall see, but everything else, the Kepler's law, everything else applies. And for instance, see example where we'll be required to use the Kepler's law, particularly the third law. You are given that the moon, as a satellite of the earth, natural satellite, each 27.3 days, given the moon orbits the earth each 27.3 days, and that it is an average distance equal here. So equal that distance, na in a orbit with the period, it means the earth is there, the moon going there with a period of 27.3, because wakikwambia kwamba ina orbit the earth each 27.3, it means they na complete the cycle. So ndo one revolution or one oscillation, so it takes that amount of days. So yon ndo time period ya the moon to orbit the earth, and therefore iko katika distance, an average distance from the center of the earth, 3.84 times 10 power 8 meters in the center of the earth. So you are told to calculate the period of artificial satellite orbiting at an average altitude of 1,500 kilometers above the earth surface. Remember, it is above the earth surface. Manake, the total distance from the center is this plus the radius of the earth. And so we know by Kepler's third law, so the square of the time period is directly proportional to the cubes of the mean distance between the two planets. And therefore, if you have T1 squared divided by T2 squared times the distance R1 cubed divided by R2 cubed. And therefore, if we make T2 squared the subject, assuming the values of 1 are for the first planet, where is the moon, and the values of 2s are for the artificial planet. And therefore, we have 2T2 squared is equal to T1 squared divided by that. If we put square root of both sides, we get T2 in sasana, T1 R2 over R1 to the root of 3 over 2. So if we put in the numbers, T1 we have 27.3 days times, ameamua ku convert kwenye hours depending on where you want to put them. If you want to put them in seconds, it is up to you. But yeah, ameamua ku convert kwenye hours. So multiply by 24 hours, you get that amount, the answer becomes in hours. So here, the R2 over R1, remember that they should have the same units. Here we have meters, here we have kilometers, here we have convert in kilometers. So converting this in kilometers divided by 1000, you get 10^5. And remember, as I say, this distance is given as distance from the Earth's surface and not from the center of the cycle. So you take this plus the distance between the center of the radius of the Earth, and we get 7880, the radius of the Earth being around 6300, and that estimate. So we get that kilometers, when you put in the numbers, put in the values, you get that amount. Another example is that the distances of two planets from the Sun are given 10^13 meters and 10^12 meters respectively. So this is for planet 1 and this is for planet 2. So the ratio of the time periods, and find the ratio of the time periods and speeds of the two planets. So according to the Kepler's third law of planetary motion, we have the T1 squared divided by T2 squared is equal to R1 cubed over R2 cubed, as we did there on top, first example. And therefore, if we find the square root of both sides, it means we're back in a T1 over T2, which is what now is the ratio of the time periods. Ni sawa sawa na R1 over R2, lakini inakuwa kwenye root ya 3/2. And therefore, the distance R1 and R2 tumepewa, remember these are the distance of the two planets from the Sun, 10^13 and 10^12. And therefore, tunapata jibu letu, the ratio to be 10 to the square root of 10, times the square root of 10. And therefore, to find the speeds of the two planets, we know that speed is equal to WR. And therefore, W is equal to 2π over T, or 2π over TR, this is equal to V. Therefore, if we take V1 over V2, itakuwa ni 2π over T1, 2π over T1, times R1, divided by 2π over T2, times R2, therefore 2π na 2π cancel, this T2 inakuja juu na T1 iko chini. Tunaona T2 iko juu, T1 chini, R1 juu, R2 chini. We have all these given. The ratio of T2 to T1 we have here. Remember, this was the ratio of T1 to T2. So here we have T2 to T1. So it is actually one of these. It is coming here, as you have seen. The ratio of R1 to R2, we are having R1 10^13, R2 10^12. Here we are putting the numbers with the answer. Another question is that in 2004, astronomers reported the discovery of large Jupiter-sized planet orbiting very close to the star HD 1799-49, hence termed a hot Jupiter. The orbit was just 1/9 the distance of Mercury from our Sun, and it takes the planet only that amount. So let us see what we are having. This is the time period, okay, to make one orbit. This is the time period. And the distance from the Sun is 1/9, the distance from the Mercury to the Sun, the distance from the Sun for that new planet that was a hot Jupiter. So what is the mass of the star? We know what we did here. Kumbuka, hapa tulifanya assumption, ikiwa this planet, this satellite is revolving around the Earth. And therefore, in the formula orbital velocity, the mass that we had is kwa mass ya Earth. So mass inaoka hapo ni mass ya kitu ambacho kipo center, sio mass ya satellite. And therefore, for this case, we're having the Sun, and therefore this mass becomes the mass of the Sun. So the formula is the same, that V is equal to G, mass of the Sun, divided by R plus H, being the mean distance from the center. So we know V is a sana W times R plus H, R plus H, which R plus H is the radius of the cycle. So this is linear velocity convention, how we relate to angular velocity. So we know also the angular velocity is equal to 2π over T times R plus h. So if we want the mass of the sun, we square both sides, so we square the velocity and remove the square root. And so if we square this, tunakuwa na 4 pi squared divide by t squared r plus h squared is equal to g square root, tunakuwa imeondoka mass of the sun divide by r plus h. So if we take r plus h here, tutaona badala ya squared, okay, this was r plus h squared. So badala ya r plus h squared inakuwa times z inakuwa r plus h cubed. So inakuwa r plus h cubed, where r plus h for this case ndo may let it be a. So that a, as you can see, ndo r plus h cubed. And this g comes down here such that we have chini huku t squared times this g. And therefore mass of the sun is equal to 4 pi squared divided by gt squared a cubed, where a is r plus h, the mean distance between the planet and the sun. And if we put in the numbers, we have everything. Remember, the distance is 1/9, the distance between the Mercury and the sun, and that is a constant. We know it is 5.79 times 10 power 10. So given that, you take 1/9 of this as the distance a, or r plus h cubed, putting the numbers, and we get that. Remember, hapa ametumia constant ya mass ya solar mass, and therefore it is known that 1 m here is equal to 1.99 times 10 power 30. So 1.11 times 1.99, you can multiply for times this, you know, part of the answer into kilograms. So it is that simple. Also, we are told to find the orbital speed. So we know that the orbital speed v is equal to 2 pi r over t, where 2 pi over t is the w. So we're having 2, we're having pi, these are constants, we're having t as the period, which is 3.09 days, convert it into seconds as they did in the previous question. Remember to convert that in seconds if you want to put your answer in kilograms, because the gravitational constant is given the units in kilograms, and therefore the r, which, as I said, is the a here, which is the r plus h, which is the mean distance from the new planet to the center of the sun, and which is 1/9 times distance between Mercury and the sun. So 1/9 distance between Mercury and the sun is 5.79 times 10 power 9. Put in the numbers and you get your answer as 151 kilometers per second. So another example, we're having a body raised to a height of 500 kilometers. The question is, what is the acceleration due to gravity at this point? And with what velocity should this body be projected in a direction perpendicular to the line joining the center of the Earth and the body, so that it describes a cycle about the Earth? What will be the period of revolution of the body about the Earth? Radius of Earth, Mepewa, give you. So, as I told you, Kwamba, if you are having the Earth, how do they put satellites? They give it, okay, the vertical velocity inaenda, inakutana na tangential force, inaipush, then inaanza ku move in circular motion. So the first question in relation to concept za mwanzo ambazo tulikuwa tumediscuss, the acceleration due to gravity. So ukiangalia hii ni variation ya g with the distance, okay, variation ya g with altitude. Kama unakumbuka variation ya g with altitude, you remember this formula, kwamba g dash inakuwa inverse proportional to the square of distance. Kwa kama huku g dash ipo huku, distance yake inakuwa huku chini, r plus h squared. Kama g ya kwenye surface ipo huku, radius ya earth ambayo ndo distance kwenye surface inakuwa juu. So you have g dash ni sasa na r squared divided by r plus h squared times g at a surface ambayo 9.8. You have the radius of the Earth, the height umepewa, 500 kilometers, which is 500,000 meters. You put it the numbers, na unapata g kwenye hiyo height is given by that. Okay? So, as for the second question, you are asked that, with what velocity should this body be projected in a direction perpendicular the line joining their centers. Okay, so the direction joining their center. You have that body here. Okay, you have that body here. You have the Earth there. So there is a velocity that should be given to this body so that it undergoes the circular motion. So the question is, with what velocity should this body be projected in direction here? So the question is, let V be the required projection velocity for the body to become artificial satellite of the Earth. Remember that hiyo vitu nao ongelea ni linear velocities, the velocity ambayo ina contribute to the centripetal force. Okay, the issue is here is that the velocity that you give for this body to undergo circular motion should be the one that will be enough to cause the centripetal force that will maintain this circular motion. Okay, because we know centripetal force is given by mv squared over r. Okay, so this velocity should be big enough to cause enough centripetal velocity so that this body undergoes circular motion. So let V be the required projection velocity for the body to become artificial satellite. Okay, if M is mass of the body. So remember, when the body is at that height, okay, so inakuwa na weight yake flat. Okay, so that weight is the result of gravitational force. So this is also equal to that gravitational force G, mass ya Earth, mass ya body, divided by distance R plus H squared. Okay, so we don't have to take trouble to this because we can simply get this. So because we have the mass, okay, anyway, the mass and mass will go away, so that eventually your V squared is equal to G dash, okay, R plus H, okay, as that. So that V squared, find V, and V will be given by G dash R plus H as given square root of that. So this is the velocity that should be given, that should be projected for that body to undergo circular motion. Kama ambavyo tuliona kwenye introduction, how the centripetal force relates to that. So the final question that you are told, that what will be the period of revolution of the body about the Earth. So we know from our circular motion, in the previous few slides, tulisema kwamba V is equal to WR. Okay, so it is that simple. And this R is the radius of the cycle about this body will undergo. And so, for this case, itakuwa ni R plus H. So we have W is sana V over R plus H. V tunayo tumeipata hapa, R plus H tunayo, and tukishapata W, tunajua hii ni sana 2 pi over T. So our final expression itakuwa ni T ni sana 2 pi, okay, R plus H divided by V. So if we have all these, and therefore we'll get our T as time period, so that the period of revolution of the body about the Earth as simple as that. So one point to note is, instead ya haya yote ambao waliyafanya, tungetumia the formula ambao tulisema kwamba V ni sawa sawa na G R E squared divided by R E plus H. You remember it here. We showed it. Okay. We showed it here. So in the formula, we could have easily got the answer. So hapa tulikuwa tunafanya tu revision namna gani tuliderive na hivyo vyote. So haina tofauti. So as I said kwamba ukiulizwa tu with what velocity should this body be projected in a direction perpendicular to joining their centers, ndo hicho nachokisema kwamba inaenda ina given a push. Okay, the velocity wanayoongelea hii na sio hii vertical projection. So you should be very careful differentiating the two. So another example that we are having, it's a similar example that we are having, yes, but advantage nini kwamba inatuonyesha sa utofauti wa velocity ambayo inakuwa projected vertically na ile push wanayopewa horizontal or tangential to the circular motion, the circular path where kwenye orbit tunaoitaka satellite ikae. So una satellite is to be put in an orbit 500 kilometers above the surface. So ukiangalia somehow linafanana na hii hapa. So it is just a repetition. Okay, it is, its vertical velocity is 2000 meters. Okay, so it's a different question kidogo at this height. Okay, the difference ni kwamba hapa tayari umeshapewa the velocity of this body at that height, okay? Yeah, so una calculate the magnitude of direction of impulse required to put the satellite directly into the orbit if its mass is 50 kilograms. So you are required kutafuta impulse, nilikwambia inakuwa projected. Ikishafika kwenye height wanayoitaka, wanaipa impulse. So the question is calculate the direction of the impulse na magnitude ambayo inabidi, kwa sababu you don't just push this anyhow. Lazima kuwe na specific direction. Yeah, where that impulse should be directed, at what angle, at what magnitude, ili iweze kukaa kwenye orbit unayoitaka. So that's what we require to find. So as usual, the first thing to do is to first calculate the velocity that the body is moving with when you orbit. Remember, hii 2000 tuliyopewa ni ya vertical velocity kutoka kwenye Earth kwenda kwenye space. I told you they are different. Kuna hii vertical velocity, kuna velocity ya kuipush kwenda undergo circular motion. So it is not this one. So first we are required to find hiyo velocity itakokuwa ina move nayo kwenye hiyo orbit ambayo ni 500 kilometers above the surface ni kiasi gani. So as usual we have our formula I told you ni sawa sana g r e okay squared divided by r plus h. So put in the numbers, g tunayo tumepewa, radius ya f tumepewa, radius ya F, tumepewa height, tumepewa, put in the numbers na unasolve unapata the velocity V ni sawa sana 7,700 meters per second. So here we are having the F projection velocity, suppose the orbit ambayo sisi tunataka ni at that point. Again we are having a tangential velocity V ambao tumeipata Vx na tuna Vy. Okay, so you remember, okay, you remember the resolving na nini. So that's what we are going to apply here. So the question is to find the impulse. Impulse of a force ni nini? So tunajua impulse of a force, okay, ni sawa sawa na momentum. Okay, change in momentum. Hiyo ndo impulse of a force. So hata wangesema a force whatever, lakini wametuliza impulse of a force. So tunajua impulse of a force ni momentum. You can refer to your second law ya Newton. So impulse of a force is momentum. So if we are having Vy, it means we are having Uy as the vertical momentum and Ux as the horizontal momentum. So we are supposed to find the resultant. Hiyo ndio itatupa magnitude na itatupa direction ya how we are supposed to make our force go, in what direction and what magnitude, which is actually very simple. Unabidi ukumbuke zile laws za the parallelogram laws na vile ambavyo mmejifunza form 2. Okay, so we are having the vertical momentum. Momentum ni sawa sana mass times velocity. So at this height, vertical momentum ambayo ilikuwa projected nayo imetoka nayo ni 2000 kwenda huko juu. Kwa inakuwa ni 50 times 2000. Okay? 50 times 2000 tuliambiwa at that height the vertical velocity ni 50 times the velocity ni 2000. Tunapata that as Uy. Then we are having the horizontal momentum. Tumeshapata velocity ambayo itakuwa tangential to the orbit ambayo sisi tunaitaka, ambayo ni sawa sana mass ya body 50 kilograms times the velocity tuliwe calculate na tukaipata hapa, ambayo ni 7,700 tukaipata in terms of that amount. So hiyo tuna Ux. So the resultant, kwa sababu hii ni A na B, the resultant will always be the hypotenuse. Okay, so we know from Pythagoras theory A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared. And therefore, we can find the resultant hapo kama ambavyo imeonekana, because that's the hypotenuse. In the base, the height, in the hypotenuse, and bond on a quite resultant. You remember your laws, Mlizo Zisoma, ikiwa huko seka from 2 na huko. So UI we have, UX we have, so to keep putting the numbers, tunakuja kupata the impulse needed in terms of magnitude is that much. Okay, so the question is to find the direction. Okay, the question is to find the direction of which this force will go. Okay, so according to the laws, okay, according to the laws of resolution, look at this diagram. The parallelogram law in a triangle, if that goes there and that goes there, the resultant will be the line passing through them. Okay, the line passing through them, and therefore we have this angle theta, of which we can get it because we have x here as ux, as uy, and this ux, and therefore we can get kwamba tan theta is equal to uy over ux. Okay, so uy we are having, which is 100,000, and ux we are having, which is 38,500 hiyo hapo. If we put in the numbers, tunatafuta tan inverse, then tunaweza tukapata the angle theta hiyo hapo. So the angle made by the total impulse with the horizontal itakuwa ni 14.6 degrees, na swali linakuwa imeishia hapo.